गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, तो वेलकम टू क्लास 11th इकोनॉमिक सेशन चैप्टर इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड। ऑल्दो वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड द चैप्टर इन द लास्ट क्लास, देयर आई टोल्ड यू द मीनिंग ऑफ इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड। नॉट ओनली आई टोल्ड यू द मीनिंग ऑफ इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड, बट ऑल्सो आई टोल्ड यू दैट देयर आर वेरियस डिग्रीज टू विच द डिमांड मे रिस्पॉन्ड। Various degrees means there are various types to which a demand may respond with respect to change in price. So I think that is clear to everybody. But before proceeding to the next topic, I would like to ask the questions and recapitulate the topic which we did yesterday. So who is going to tell me that what is the meaning of elasticity of demand? Forget about elasticity of demand. Just tell me the single word meaning of elasticity. What is meant by elasticity? I'm not talking about elasticity of demand. Just give me the single word meaning of elasticity. Neelima Jain. Neelima, you can speak now. We can hear you. I have unmuted you. Neelima, some problem is there in your mic, I guess, because I can see you. You are speaking, but your mic is not working. Okay. Darshika, what is meant by elasticity?
Sir, the percentage change in demand for a commodity.
Tell me just the meaning of elasticity. Just the meaning of the word elasticity.
The change in demand.
Changeability. Elasticity refers to changeability. But when we say that what is elasticity of demand, we simply say changeability of demand. And what is meant by price elasticity of demand? Namish, you are going to tell me what is meant by price elasticity of demand.
Price elasticity of demand is the ratio of percentage change in demand percentage change in price,
which means what is the percentage change in price gives us the percentage change in demand. For example, if there is percentage change in price by 20%, okay, Rakesh wants to tell. Yes, Rakesh, you can speak. I have unmuted you.
Sir, price elasticity of demand refer the percentage change in demand for a commodity with reference to change in the price of such commodity.
Fine. That with reference to the change in price of a commodity. For example, if there is change in price by 10%, then what is the resultant change in demand? That is the elasticity of demand, price elasticity of demand. We did some degrees also that demand may respond in various ways with respect to change in price. For example, if the price has risen by 10%, then demand may respond in various ways. Can you tell me what were the various ways by which demand may respond? Demand jo hai kis tarah se respond kar sakti hai? Sameer Goyal wants to tell. Yes, Sameer, you can speak.
First is perfectly inelastic demand.
Perfectly inelastic.
Inelastic
demand. What happens in perfectly inelastic? Elaborate also.
When the product increases the price of in 20%, so the demand is perfectly
perfectly inelastic means that there is no change at all in the demand. Perfectly inelastic. Inelastic is
100%.
100% inelastic, which means there will not be any change whether the price is rising or not. The demand is constant, right? The next one is
highly elastic demand.
Okay, next one I would like to ask from Dhruv Bansal. Dhruv?
Sir, second one is highly elastic demand. When percentage change in quantity demanded is higher than the percentage change in price.
Can you give an example, please?
If a quantity of tea demanded decreases by 20%,
we will say just highly elastic. Highly elastic means the demand is changing more than the change in price. example, if price has risen by 10%, then the demand is the resultant change in demand is more than the 10%. Say it is 15% or 20% or 30%. That is highly elastic demand. Perfect. So now I would like to ask the third one, that is less elastic demand. Who is going to tell me the third one? Kindly raise your hand. Less elastic demand. Harshita. Yes, Harshita.
Sir, when the percentage change in the quantity demanded is less than the percentage in price.
Less than the percentage change in price, which means when the demand is changed by less as compared to the change in price, then it is known as less elastic demand. Okay, my next question is unitary elastic demand. Raise your hands. Abhi Bansal, you will tell me unitary elastic demand. Abhi. Abhi, you are going to tell me unitary elastic demand. Okay, Anshika Garg want to tell. Anshika Garg, you can speak.
So when percentage change in the quantity demand is equal to the percentage change in the price.
Perfect. When we simply say that the percentage change, we got it. That when the percentage change in price is equals to percentage change in demand. That means the demand and price both are changing in the same proportion. All right. And what is the last perfectly elastic demand? Perfectly elastic demand. Abhi, when I was asking you from with a mic, I think you would have speak in that, not in the chat box. Next time, please take care. Harshita, perfectly elastic.
Sir, percentage change in the price. Price the quantities change to infinity.
We will simply say even without the change in price, the demand changes infinitely. That is basically the perfectly elastic. For example, even without the change in price, the product becomes out of fashion, out of trend. You know, the price is same, but still we are not liking that product now. So we have changed our demand. So other factors can be there or exceptions can be there. Okay, so let's move further. Moving now to the next topic of this same chapter, which we were doing. We were doing elasticity of demand, and I told you different degrees that can be there. So one by one, I'm taking that degree once again with the help of the schedule and diagram, as you can see on your screen. The first was perfectly elastic demand. Perfectly elastic means that there is infinite change in demand with no change in price. As you can see, the price is same. Price earlier was also 30, now is also 30, and again price is same, but the demand is changing from 100, 200, 300. This is called perfectly elastic demand, which means the demand is changing infinitely without change in price. But when it will happen? Ye kaun se case mein hoga perfectly elastic demand? Even without change in price, the demand is changing. Even without change in price, the demand is changing. Maybe the, you know, exceptional goods or the exceptions see this diagram. The price is same in all cases. The price is 30, which is in all cases. But the demand was earlier 100, then 100, 200, 300. Can you see the demand is changing this way, vertical, but price is horizontal. Price is same. So here, this is the diagram of perfectly elastic demand. Now moving further, if we talk about the second point, that is perfectly inelastic demand. What will be perfectly inelastic? Perfectly inelastic means bilkul bhi change nahi ho raha, which when there is no change in demand, the change in price. Whether the price is changing, but there is no change in demand. It's perfectly inelastic demand. Elastic demand means the demand is not changing. Perfectly means 100% it is not changing. That means demand is constant. Ab yahan pe kya karenge? Demand is constant. Price bad raha hai, price 20, 30, 40 price increase ho raha hai, and demand is constant, that is 100, 100, 100. So this way, aapko kya diagram mil raha hai yahan pe? Because price is changing, 30, 20, 40, but the demand is same. So this way, this is our demand curve, यहाँ पर ये वाली डिमांड कब डी डी रिप्रेजेंट्स का डिमांड सो यहाँ पे ये डिमांड कब हमारी होगी विच इज वर्टिकल लाइन पैरेलल टू वाई एक्सिस सो दिस इज परफेक्टली इलास्टिक डिमांड सो इट्स परफेक्टली इन इलास्टिक डिमांड व्हाई इट इज टर्मड एज ईडी इक्वल्स टू जीरो बिकॉज ईडी इज इक्वल्स टू जीरो मीन्स इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड इज इक्वल्स टू जीरो means changeability of demand is zero मतलब बिल्कुल भी change नहीं हो रहा तो of course यही तो name है इसका perfectly inelastic demand moving further third highly elastic demand means when percentage change in quantity demanded is more than the percentage change in price जब demand में ज़्यादा change हो रहा है इससे तो what we will say we will call it highly elastic demand can you see in the schedule earlier price was 20 the demand was 100 units Now the price has become 10, which means 50% कम हो गया price. The demand तो of course बढ़ेगी because inverse relation होता है. Price has fallen by 50%. The demand has risen to you know 200 by 50% by 100%. Demand 100% से बढ़ गई. Definitely percentage change in demand is more than the percentage change in price. Price में कितना change हुआ था? Price में change हुआ था 50% का because पहले price 20 half of हो गया 50% का प्राइस चेंज हुआ डिमांड में कितना चेंज हुआ डिमांड में मोर देन 50% का चेंज हुआ डिमांड वाज अर्लियर 100 देन 200 हो गई मींस डिमांड में 100% का चेंज हो गया दैट इज हाईली इलास्टिक डिमांड व्हिच मींस व्हेन देयर इज मोर द चेंज इन डिमांड इज मोर द चेंज इन तो सी द डायग्राम अर्लियर प्राइस वाज 20 तो उस टाइम पे हमारा क्वांटिटी कितना था 100 यूनिट्स फिर प्राइस हो गया 10 तो उस टाइम पे हमारा क्वांटिटी कितना हो गया 200 units. So price में 50% से decrease हुआ, जबकि demand में 100% से increase हो गया. So this would be the demand curve. Demand curve would be like this. It is more flatter because जितना elasticity है ज़्यादा होता जाएगा. It will become more flatter in nature. All right? और ज़्यादा जो है flatter होती जाएगी curve. ठीक है? Now next point. The next point is known as less elastic demand. As I told you. Less elastic demand means what will be the what is the less elastic demand? Less elastic demand that the demand is less elastic. There is less percentage change in demand, right? The percentage change in quantity demanded is less than the percentage change in price. Example, as you can see, that price was earlier 20, then kitna ho gaya? 10 ho gaya. Price comes from 20 to 10. The demand curve rises from 100 to 120 डिमांड का 100 से 120 हो गया तो प्राइस अगर 20 से 10 हुआ डिमांड का 100 से 120 हो गई ऑफ कोर्स प्राइस कम हुआ आपका 10% से डिमांड जो है आपका प्राइस कम हुआ आपका 50% से डिमांड आपका सिर्फ 20% से ही बढ़ी ऑफ कोर्स दैट इज लेस इलास्टिक डिमांड दैट द चेंज इन डिमांड इज लेस देन द चेंज इन प्राइस सो इट्स डायग्राम वुड बी लाइक दिस पहले प्राइस था 20 तो क्वांटिटी था 100 Price हो गया 10 तो क्वांटिटी हो गया 120 means change in price is more by 50% but change in demand is less than only by 20% so this would be demand curve in this case the demand curve is steeper in nature थोड़ी steeper है पिछले वाले केस में more वाले में it was flatter लेकिन इस वाले में it is steeper last is unitary elastic means the percentage change in demand is equals to percentage change in price The price is 20. When the price was 20, demand was 100 units. When the price has now fallen to 10 units only, which means decreased by 50%, the demand has risen to 150. That is increased by 50%, which means the 50% change in price has resulted in 50% change in demand of the commodity. So that is also same. ED equals to 1, unitary elastic demand. When price was 20, The demand comes to 100 units. The when price comes to 10 units, the demand comes to 150 units. So it is ultimately unitary elastic demand. Jitna change price mein hua, utna hi change demand mein hua. So this is called unitary elastic demand, which we call it ED is equals to 1. So I hope this is clear. Yahan tak pehle clear hai, tell me all 5 points which we studied yesterday and description today. Is it clear to all? Okay. Now I just want that if you should just tell me the complete topic once again of elasticity of demand. This only. That how what are the degrees of elasticity of demand, right? So who is going to tell me the complete? Sameer wants to tell. Yes, Sameer, you over to you. Sameer, you can speak.
Sir, degrees of elasticity of demand. First is a perfectly elastic demand. Then three is an infinite degree at a particular price. And demand becomes zero with a slight rise in the price. It's known as perfectly elastic demand.
Okay.
And second is highly elastic demand, when percentage change in the quantity demanded is more than the percentage change in price, is known as highly elastic demand.
Okay.
Third is less elastic demand, when percentage change in the quantity demanded is less than percentage change in price, is known as less elastic demand.
Okay.
And fourth is unitary elastic demand. Unitary elastic demand is a demand in which the given percent is same.
Hmm.
10%, so the demand is fallen.
Okay.
And the last is perfectly inelastic demand. Perfectly inelastic demand refers to the demand is become zero.
Okay. So, anybody else, anyone else want to tell all the points together? Dhruv Bansal. Yes, Dhruv, you are unmuted.
Sir, first one is perfectly inelastic demand, when there is no change in demand with change in price or even with even not change in price. Second one is highly elastic demand, when percentage change in quantity demanded is higher than the percentage change in price.
Okay.
Third one is less elastic demand, when percentage change in quantity demanded is less than the percentage change in price.
Okay.
And fourth one is unitary elastic demand, when percentage change in quantity demanded is equal to percentage change in price. And the last one is perfectly elastic demand, when there is an infinite change in demand with change in price.
Okay, fine. So anyone else would like to tell? Because this is a very important concept. I want that everybody should know it very well. Then only I would be moving to the next question. Krishna is asking for explanation of less elasticity of demand once again. Khushi, I would like you to ask, I would like you to tell the meaning of less elasticity of demand so that it is clear to Kanishka also. Over to you.
Less, when the percentage change in the quantity demanded is less than the percentage change in price, this refers to less elastic demand.
No, less elastic is when the percentage change in demand is less than the percentage change in price. Example, the change in price by 20%, but the demand has responded in a change with less than 20%. It could be termed as less elasticity of demand, or ED less than 1. Anyone else? Vidhanshi, I would like you to please switch on your camera. Vidhanshi. Because I'm, I think you are coming today after 3-4 days. Because I have not seen you in previous classes. And I would like you to please be regular. Okay. Who is going to tell me again? Anyone else would like to tell? You can raise your hand. Anurag Das, can you listen to me? Anurag Das.
Yes, sir.
Just tell me the meaning of elasticity.
Elasticity?
Yes. What is the meaning of elasticity?
Elasticity means...
what we have studied in today's class. Switch on your camera. Anurag.
Yes, sir.
Switch on your camera. What you have studied in today's class? Tell me. Okay, I'll talk to your parents. Okay, so let's moving towards the next topic first. Next question which I would like to tell here. Factors affecting price elasticity of demand. Now there are some factors which may affect the price elasticity of demand. Factors affecting price elasticity of demand. Actually, what is there in the factors? I would just give you some factor and you have to just tell me like whether yahan pe elasticity jyada hogi ya kam hogi. For example, availability of substitutes, as you can see on your screen, availability of substitutes. Tell me if the substitute of a products are available in the market. If the substitutes of our products are available in the market, what will happen to its elasticity? Tell me. Okay, Namish Jalan is saying high elasticity. Okay, so anyone else? Become more is saying it will be more. Okay, of course, Dushyant is saying high. Dhruv Gupta, high elasticity. Because if substitutes are available in the market, substitute means the same kind of product is available in the market, then elasticity is of course more. If you feel like, if you see in the market that there are many offerings available, I can go for Coca-Cola, I can go for Pepsi, I can go for Limca or Mirinda or Fanta or many other, you know, substitutes are available for the soft drinks. If one is not there, if suppose you didn't find Coca-Cola in the market, definitely you will go to Thumbs Up or you will go to you know, Pepsi, or you'll go to in orange brand, you'll go to Fanta, Mirinda, Limca. There are many substitutes available. Whenever there are many substitutes available in the market, the elasticity is always very high. There is a best possible case that the consumer is definitely going to shift to the other because of the more substitutes available in the market. But when we say that there are no substitutes or less substitutes available in the market, then definitely there will be less, you know, elasticity in the market. So in the factors, you have to just tell only whether there would be high elasticity or less elasticity. So if more substitutes are available in the market, there would be highly elastic demand. If less substitutes are available in the market, there will be low elastic or less elastic demand. All right. Everybody is giving the correct answer in the chat box. Harshita is saying, sir, due to substitute, the demand for the particular commodity will be less. Of course, yes, because we have already covered it in the factors affecting demand also. Because the price of one commodity affects the demand of other substitute as well. So availability of substitute, I think you all have covered. Now see the first point. The first point of this is nature of commodity. If I find that the nature of the commodity is a basic necessity, then what will happen? If a product is a basic necessity product, basic necessity means you can't survive with that product. What will happen in that case? The elasticity will be less or more? Okay, I got answer from Namish. He's saying low elasticity because we have to, you know. Ambika is also saying no change. Prashant, low elasticity. Kushi, Dhruv Gupta. Dhruv Gupta is saying more elasticity. Dhruv, no, there would not be more elasticity. I would like to just talk to Dhruv Gupta. Dhruv Gupta. Where is Dhruv Gupta? I want to clear your doubt here only, because otherwise you will keep in your mind the wrong concept. Dhruv Gupta. Wait, Dhruv, I'm just searching you to unmute you. Kahan gaye Dhruv Gupta? Dhruv Gupta, yes, I got you. Dhruv, now tell me what you wanted to say. More elasticity in case of necessities. How? Dhruv, you can speak. you know, low elasticity in case of basic necessities?
So because these are our basic necessities for survival. So if the price will increase, so there is no change in demand because they are.
Because ultimately, hota kya hai ki if basic necessities are there, then definitely we are going to buy that even if there is high price of that commodity. So there is less elasticity. And what happened in case of the luxury goods? Luxury goods, like if I talk about AC, I talk about DVD player, I talk about refrigerator. What will happen in case of luxury goods? Definitely there will be more elasticity because a change in price, a slight change in price, I'm going to shift my demand. I'm not going to buy that commodity today or now, right? Okay, fine. So moving further, income level. If the income level of the consumer is so high, do you think a slight change in price is going to affect its demand or elasticity? Tell me in the chat box. If the income level of a consumer is already very high, agar main bahut achhi income kama raha hu, to agar mujhe lag raha hai commodity, agar desi ghee, agar 500 rupees per kg se 550 rupees per kg bhi ho jaye, is it going to change my elasticity? Whether there will be changeability in demand? So elasticity of demand for any commodity is generally less for high income level group, right? Jo high income level group ke log hote hain, unke liye elasticity kam rehti hai. लेकिन जो लो इनकम लेवल के ग्रुप के लोग होते हैं उनके लिए इलास्टिसिटी ज्यादा होती है. अर्निंग लेस ना, व्हेन अर्निंग लेस देन डेफिनेटली देयर वुड बी हाईली इलास्टिक डिमांड विल चेंज यू नो हाईली इलास्टिकली. बट इफ आई टॉक अबाउट द लो इनकम लेवल ग्रुप विल बी हाईली इलास्टिक. बट इफ आई टॉक अबाउट द हाई इनकम लेवल ग्रुप, दोज हु आर ऑलरेडी अर्निंग हैंडसम सैलरी, हैंडसम इनकम, देन डेफिनेटली देयर वुड बी लेस इलास्टिक और इनइलास्टिक डिमांड. परफेक्ट. This level of price. Okay, tell me the low level of price commodities. Take the example of matchbox, needle. Already, jo 2 rupees ka aata hai, 1 rupees ka aata hai, 5 rupees ka aata hai. The commodity which was costing earlier rupees 3, now that commodity is costing you rupees 4. Will you change the demand? Already, you will say already itna sasta hai, cheap product, level of price so low. You are not going to change its demand, which means the products whose price is somewhere, you know, less, too less. Consumer can easily afford that commodity. Elasticity is almost nil, inelastic. When we talk about the high level of priced commodity, for example, I'm talking about laptop, I'm talking about air condition, I'm talking about a computer, I'm talking about a refrigerator, I'm talking about a washing machine. Definitely, these commodities are high-level priced commodities. The slight change in price of these commodities is definitely going to impact the demand for sure. So, elasticity is more in that case. Do write in the chat box if there is any doubt till now, or show me your thumb so that I can move to the other points. All right, perfect. So, theek hai, let's move. Siddhi ka doubt hai, if the commodity is a basic necessity, then won't it be perfectly inelastic? Yeah, you can say it, Siddhi. It's same, highly inelastic or perfectly, you can say. Okay, moving further to the next point. The next point is postponement of consumption. See the fifth point, postponement of consumption. Postponement of consumption, if suppose consumer can postpone the use of a particular commodity. If I think I would not like to buy the commodity this month, I would be buying that commodity in the next month, right? So postponement of consumption somewhere takes place, like commodities like biscuits, soft drinks, etc., whose demand is not urgent, right? And have highly elastic demand. If that demand postponed ho sakta hai, that means those commodities are not urgent commodities, demand will be highly elastic. But jinka demand postponed nahi ho sakta, which means those who are the urgent commodities, the consumption is urgent, then definitely the demand is less elastic. So I'll simply say more elastic in the case of the demand can be postponed, and inelastic, less elastic for those commodities which can't be postponed. All right. Now, share in the total expenditure first. Share in the total expenditure. Share in the total expenditure, for example, while making a budget for your home, I do mention various commodities. Whenever I make budget for my home, I do mention various commodities in that. Commodities like desi ghee, which costs you almost around 300 per kg, to commodities like matchbox, which costs you hardly rupees 2 or 3 per matchbox. Somewhere, if the commodity which have a high share of total expenditure in a budget, budget month 5,000 rupees All right, so we have to pick up this thing also, the share in total expenditure. If I say the total expenditure, if the share in the total expenditure is high or is more, then definitely there would be more elasticity, right? If the share in total expenditure is less, then definitely there will be less elasticity of demand. Habit of the consumer. Now, what happens in terms of habit? The product is in the habit of the consumer, habitual necessity. I told you this point in exception to law of demand also. If the product is in the habit of the consumer, definitely because of the habitual necessity, he is going to buy the product. Those product ko jarur buy karega, even if the price rises. So elasticity will be less or high? Elasticity will be less, of course. But if I talk about the, if I am not talking about the habit of the consumer, then definitely the product is not the habit, it will be less problem. All right, so I would like to, if anybody give me the explanation of these 6-7 points which we have just studied, who is going to give me the explanation of any these 4-5 points? You can raise your hand. Explanation for these 4-5 points, please. So that, or one by one, we want to explain. Okay. Dhika, I want to ask you, Dhruv Bansal is asking to repeat the postponement point. Postponement of use ka matlab tha, if a consumer can postpone the use of a particular commodity, right? If I can postpone, that means the commodity is not urgent to me. If the commodity is not urgent to me, then definitely its elasticity will be less or more. More, because I can postpone. If I cannot postpone the use of the commodity, which means that is most urgent to me, its elasticity will be less. Samir Goyal is asking to repeat the total expenditure. Total expenditure means if in the budget, share of which you are going to tell have a more budget, a more share in the total expenditure. कुछ प्रोडक्ट्स को इनका टोटल एक्सपेंडिचर में काफी बड़ा शेयर होता है तो उनकी इलास्टिसिटी ज्यादा होती है लेकिन कुछ छोटे-छोटे प्रोडक्ट्स भी होते हैं जैसे कि मैच बॉक्स जैसे कि नीडल और कुछ ऐसे प्रोडक्ट भी घर में आते हैं जिनका टोटल एक्सपेंडिचर बहुत कम शेयर होता है तो डेफिनेटली इलास्टिसिटी विल बी लेस ओके So, we'll do the topic, further topic tomorrow. Till then, please repeat the topic once again. Revise the topic once again at home and we'll definitely recap this topic once again tomorrow in the class. So, till then, take care.